If I could, I would collect stars from the heaven, pluck the moon from the sky, gather tender whispering breezes, catching the comets trailing by, round up planets traveling galaxies, the fragrance spilling from the flowers, notes of birdsong spiraling eddies, drops of felicity from summer showers. I would wrap them up with ribbons and offer them to you in exchange for a single happy smile, precious as the morning dew. A smile looks awesome on you. A smile. Smiling is infectious. You can catch it like the flu. When somebody smiled at me today, I started smiling too. I passed around the corner and someone saw my grin. When he smiled, I realized I passed it on to him. I thought about my smile and then I realized its worth. A single smile like mine could travel right around the earth. If you feel a smile begin, don't leave it undetected. Let's start an epidemic quick and get the world infected. Let me see your smile.
I'm sorry. Second, she lets it go.
Chloe Grace to Twitter.
Welcome to Shrek.
Hi, I'm Rachel Jones and I'm an artist. I thought I was going to be an animator when I was a child because I didn't know that I could be an artist, or I'd never seen an artist that looked like me. And then I was like, no, if I don't do this then I'll just be really disappointed and like quite sad. In all of the paintings, there were teeth or like lips. Like there were really big teeth with like one hair and then one hair. You see these lines?
What inspired you to do pictures of like mouths?
You feel a lot of different things in your mouth, and your mouth is a point in your body where things go into it and things come out, and there are lots of different like sensations in your mouth and textures. I'm interested in how to talk about what you might feel inside your body, and I use teeth and lips and the mouth as a symbol for that. I get stuck all the time. I think because I don't know what I'm going to end up making when I start painting, there's always this question of what direction should this go in? You have to be willing to make some terrible mistakes sometimes to get to a point where the work looks good enough where you feel like it's finished. And I think that's normal with like lots of things in life.
What's your favourite colour?
Ooh, red.
Blue.
Blue? What's your favourite colour?
Magenta.
Oh, very specific. Okay, I like that. These paintings have less red than I would normally put in a painting, but I was trying not to use it too much because it's very easy to make things with the colours that you like, isn't it? And then not to use colours you don't like. Every single painting I make covers the entire spectrum of the rainbow. So red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple, pink, brown, black and white. It's not always visible because the way I work is in layers, so some colours will be hidden and others will be far more visible.
Like what types of materials do you use?
I use only oil pastels and oil sticks, but I use them in lots of different ways. So sometimes I put them on and then I blend it with my hand so it's smooth like this, and sometimes I just draw like a line, and sometimes I'll do lots of lines close to each other. So I like to do different things to get different effects, you know?
Do you use anything to smudge, like blend in the colours?
No, you can. You can use different types of mediums if you want to, and you can use a brush to blend things out, but I just use my hands. Taking tools away meant that I think the flow of my ideas and my thoughts came out of my body through my hand onto the painting a lot more
quickly and naturally, and I really liked that.
Do you ever make paintings with scrap paper?
But I think scrap paper is great, like anything which is stuff that you might put in the bin or things that aren't perfect and have like funny edges. Everything has value, like it can all be made into something special for you, so.
Do you ever have to use a ladder?
Oh no, but I stand on a chair sometimes.
Why is your art so abstract?
It's abstract because I think that sometimes it's hard to talk about things through like clear pictures, and if something is abstract, it can be interpreted in lots of different ways. So you can see lots of different things in them, can't you? And I made them like that, so your imagination allows you to like think about what it is you see.
And there's some water over here.
Like rocks and stuff.
That looks like a snake.
That looks like a tongue.
That looks like something with red eye.
It's really important to believe in yourself and to value the feelings and thoughts that you have. So just surround yourself with the types of opportunities that allow you to grow and to learn and to think and to ask questions. That's really important. Anyone can be an artist, 100%. Yes. The next time you make something, why don't you think about how you can use different colours to describe emotions in a way that you haven't before? You could have yellow with green, and those two things together might mean something very different to yellow and red.
Alright students, time for our Rachel Jones abstract art project. Now first we're going to look at Picasso, the father of abstract art. And you can see how he had these bulls and changed them from a normal bull into an abstract bull. And then he made it into shapes and colors to make them more unique and more interesting. Now Rachel Jones, she looked at art differently. She is trying to show feelings and trying to show emotions, as she talked about in the quote right before this. And I want you to think about what colors and some part of you that you would like to emphasize. It could be some of the clothes you wear, some of a facial feature. Like Rachel Jones focused on smiles, because she felt like smiles or mouths could show so many different expressions, so many feelings. Big teethy grin, like we saw in the videos before. It shows beauty, it shows anger, it shows happiness, it shows many things. Now, she didn't make it look like a realistic mouth. She just made it look like teeth and mouth and the shapes that they make, and then added color. You can see that Rachel Jones was also in Harper's Bazaar and many other magazines as well. All right, guys, here are some new pastel techniques that I want you to use in this project.
Just do this because it looks really neat, and sometimes oil pastel can be a little bit scruffy. So by putting the masking tape down, just helps it out. Now, the first one, what I'm going to do is using the oil pastel relatively lightly. Now, I'm just overlapping some of the colours on there. You'll still be able to see the whiteness coming through. And that's just because I handle it lightly. A lot of people using oil pastels actually will use it in this way, but just not overlapping it enough. Now, what I'll also do with this is adding some of the white in there, and that will blend naturally some of the colours together. It'll also bring out that colour and make it different tones and hues. So I'm just doing some hatching on there, subtly blending colours together. Now the next one, what I'm going to be doing is similar, blending colours together, but I'm going to be working a lot harder in there, and you'll see that there's no white coming through the page. And I'm really using the technique of applying a lighter colour, this I'm just using white with blue, and blending it. So I'm overlapping, so I'm never going just up to the colour, I'm always going over the top of it, and that's how you're going to get those colours naturally mixing. Now I'm going to carry on mixing these colours, just using a variety of different tones. So I might have a number of different greens, transitioning to yellow, and just trying to work out what happens if I overlap a lighter colour, what happens if I overlap it with white, does it take down the intensity down? I'll say yellow can be quite translucent. By adding the white, it's going to become a little bit more opaque, and just kind of killing those colours. Sometimes you will see all your pastels just looking a little bit too harsh, so I'm just making them a little bit softer. Now this one, what I'm going to be doing is called Sgraffito. Now I'm using this technique for a particular image that I'm going to be showing you later on. It's going to be of the reeds. So first of all, what I'm going to do is put a lighter colour down first. I'm just using some yellows, some whites, also some like peachy tones, and also maybe a subtle brown. Then I'm going to put a green over the top of it, and hopefully it should go over the top no problem. You can use, as long as it's a darker colour, that should be fine. So any darker colour that you use will work. And what I'm doing now, just using a skewer, and you can see that the image that I'm looking at there, looking at the reeds, and I'm scratching through those lighter areas. And hopefully anything sharp you could use a pair of scissors if you wanted to, or a ruler or anything sharp should be able to work no problem. Now I'm going to put some darker tones in there using some greens, and that's just going to add it some more contrast, and then just go back over the top with the Sgraffito. So really quite nice technique on that one. This one here, obviously oil pastel is made up of oil, which is the same as oil painting. So if you add some turpentine, which is a mineral spirit, and add it to it, you're going to thin it down. Not a lot of people know this, and it's really quite nice, especially if you just want that subtle tone from dark to light. You can also use some oil like baby oil, that works as well. Now with any technique, it's always good to do some mark making, working out how you're going to handle the material, how you're going to get those marks on there. I'm just doing some dashes, maybe using the side of the oil pastel, twisting it in my hand, pressing lightly, varied weight of line, and then just combining a number of colours together. So I'm not necessarily mixing the colours, but I'm overlapping the colours, and from a distance it should bring up those colours together as one rather than being very separate. So I'll do that for a short while, just so the full box is completed. And then here's the last one. Now it's similar to Sgraffito really, and I've never really used this technique, but I thought it was quite nice. Just put a number of colours down. I say I'm using some quite earthy colours on here. Just fill out the page as much as you can with some colours. I'll just put it on a scrap piece of paper. And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to turn over the piece of paper. Use the skewer again. You can use anything, maybe a pen or a pencil, I'm sure they will work as well. And now again, I'm just going to do some more mark making. And what I should see is actually each mark making that I do will have that almost different variety of colour all mixing into one, which I thought was really quite cool actually. So I really like that one.
Alright guys, now you're going to be doing the pastels over the paintings we did last week. If you did not do a painting, you may start doing that today and letting that dry, and then we'll do the pastels on top. I want to do layers. I want to see these six different techniques that you just learned on top of the pastel, creating an awesome abstract artwork basing on some part of your body or your who you are with clothes or whatnot, just like I said previously in the video. Okay, all right guys, have fun.